I'm teaching a grad class, a class for those people who have been Christians for quite a while but want more. It's built on three things. One is the foundation of the gospel. Do you know the gospel? Do you know the apostles' teachings? Do you know your way through Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, etc., so that you can give an account of your faith? When someone asks you, are you equipped to do that? That's what we spend a lot of time with on Sunday mornings. But the second part to that is that we become people of character, that God builds within us a dignity, a way of life that stands apart in the community because God's got a hold of you. And so we work on our character. But the third part, kind of where we're going today, is that we are called to mission. We're not called just to get converted. We get converted to follow Jesus so that we can go out into the world and be salt and light to a world that so desperately needs it. And that's part of what we're about today. I'm going to read to you some scripture from the prophet Isaiah. And that text talks about not Jesus just dying for your sins per se, but how he set the captives free. That the heart of God is that we are out in this world being that salt and light. So let me read to you from the 58th chapter of the prophet Isaiah. This is some 600 years before the birth of Jesus. Is not this the kind of fasting I have chosen? To loose the chains of injustice and untie the cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free and break every yoke? Is it not to share your food with the hungry? To provide the poor wanderer with shelter when you see the naked, to clothe them, and not to turn away from your own flesh and blood? And then your light will break forth like the dawn, and your healing will quickly appear. Then your righteousness will go before you, and the glory of the Lord, the glory of the Lord will be your rear guard. You think you're alone, you're not. And then you will cry, and the Lord will answer. You will cry for help, and he will say, here I am. If you do away with the yoke of oppression, with the pointing finger and the malicious talk, and if you spend yourselves on behalf of the hungry, satisfy the needs of the oppressed, then your light will rise in the darkness, and your night will become like the noonday. The Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land, will strengthen your frame. And you will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail. Your people will rebuild the ancient ruins and will raise up the age-old foundations. You will be called repairer of broken walls, restorer of streets with dwellings. This is the heart of God, friends. And he spoke to the prophet. Today, kind of coming out of our outreach committee, the people who are trying to provide leadership in this church about all the ministry opportunities, whether it's refugees, whether it's the Barnabas ministry, whether it's the work in Jamaica. But here is a piece, and it's called Christians Against Poverty. And we have Jolene with us today, guest speaker, and you're going to be there with Mark. Your husband is with us. And she's going to share the word with us. This is a ministry that I believe that we need to consider, to take seriously. That God will bless us if we maybe roll up our sleeves and do this ministry. What I want you to know is that there are many people who wear a suit and tie, who look really proper, and are living in hell. They're house poor. Their marriages are fragile because the finances at home are unmanageable. And they need help and direction. I'm going to leave you this, that I have a role of confidentiality in this parish as your senior minister. My job often is that I know stories that are going on all over the place, but I can't talk to you about them. And you don't know each other's stories, but I know the stories. I believe this is a ministry that we need, part of this Minster model. So Jolene, you're going to come forward. Why don't you come up and bless us with the word about Christians Against Poverty, an amazing ministry. God bless.
Well, thank you so much, Pastor Drew, Pastor Guy, for having me here this morning. It is an absolute honor. Just the worship this morning was really encouraging and definitely feeling blessed by what God is doing in your church and in your congregation. As Pastor Drew said, my name is Jolene Goulet, and I am the Church Partnership Manager at CAP and have been doing that for the last 3 years. And it is my role to talk to churches, inspire churches, to get them involved with this life-transforming work across the GTA. Now, a little bit about myself. I previously worked in the credit lending industry. The different side. And I was in there for a number of years, and I stepped away to start my own family. And as I was looking to get back to work, I was praying and asking God what it is that He would have me do in using that experience that I have had in that industry. And on a Sunday morning, just like this, I heard that call from God to get involved with Christians Against Poverty as they had a speaker. And so I wanted to get involved any way I could. And as I started volunteering and then working at that organization, I was renewed in the belief that equipped with the right tools and resources, the church can be effective in its ministry to its community through this. And that, through it, we can bring the light of the gospel into people's homes, that people that are living in darkness, as Pastor Drew said. Now, to help you understand who CAP is, I think it's important that we see where it started. And so CAP started in the UK 22 years ago by a gentleman called John Kirkby. Now, John was a successful entrepreneur in the business, the financial industry. However, in the late 80s, when there was a housing crash, this massive recession, John was affected by it. And his world just crumbled around him. And you can see here what happened is that he lost his job, he lost his home, his marriage fell apart, nothing. He literally had nothing and ended up staying with his two little girls in shared accommodation, and they were just on some makeshift beds there. John felt the fear and the failure, the worry and the depression, and that isolation and despair that comes through overwhelming debt, that comes through poverty. But praise God that God had not abandoned John. And I want to be clear here to say that there is always hope. There is always hope. And as the church, we get to believe that, right? We get to own that. That is ours. There is always hope in Jesus. And so, in John's darkest hour, he encountered something beautiful. He encountered the local church, a church just like this. He heard that gospel message, and he was given an opportunity to respond to the gospel message, which is key, and he gave his life to Christ. He gave everything over to begin following Jesus. You can see here John was baptized shortly after, and through this process, starting to rebuild his life, he continued to be supported and loved and cared for by the church. He eventually found another job and met his future wife, Lizzie. And in the summer of 1996, just as they were about to get married, God challenged John. Who was going to care and bring hope to the many others that are facing the same hurts and the same pains and the same struggles that he had had in his hometown of Bradford? And so, thankfully, John decided to follow God, to give up his new job, and start something new, doing the only thing that he knew how to do. And so John sat down at a computer and wrote the words debt counseling, and they're Christians Against Poverty. You can see it's actually misspelled there. He has dyslexia, but he says that doesn't stop him. There is always hope. And in that tiny bedroom office, that is where CAP was born. And since that time, the growth in the UK is nothing short of miraculous. And I know there are some of you here today that can attest to that miraculous spread of the gospel and of the hope that we have in Jesus across that nation. There is over 600 poverty-busting services in partnership with the local church making an impact in that community. And we also serve the countries of Australia, New Zealand, and now 5 years here in Canada. And in any of the countries we serve, the mission is always the same: to serve the poor, to save the lost, with the church, and across this nation. And as we've already read, the Bible is very clear about God's heart towards the poor and our responsibility as Jesus followers. The first couple of verses that Pastor Drew read, is this not the kind of fasting I have chosen, to loose the chains of injustice and untie the cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your food with the hungry and to provide the poor wanderer with shelter? When you see the naked, to clothe them and not turn away from your own flesh and blood. And I could go on, but when I read these verses, to me, it suggests that ministry to the poor is not merely giving things. It's not merely meeting sort of an emergency need, but it's more than that. It is giving of yourself. That part where it says, you will draw the soul for the hungry. There is something that it costs something to us to serve those who most need it. And so it is not just relief, it's relationship. And praise God that we are on his mission. God's in this thing. And it says at the end in verse 12 that your people will rebuild the ancient ruins and will raise up the age-old foundations. That is talking to us. It is talking to the Christian Canadian church here. And it says that we will, hear this, be called repairer of broken walls. Is that not something you want to be known for? It certainly is something I want to be known for, where we are literally putting homes back together, where we are literally bringing families that are being torn apart by poverty, and we are giving them hope again. We are going to be called restorer of streets with dwellings. Amen? That is God's heart. It was in Isaiah's time before, 600 years before Jesus came, and it is now, and it will be forevermore. God is calling us to be a church that generously gives of our resources, our time, our energy, and our money to serve those in need, no matter how difficult it is. And if we choose to step out into our communities, there is hope. And so our focus of our mission statement, to serve the poor. Recently, we've become fully accredited members with the Canadian Association of Credit Counseling Services. Now, this is an organization that has been governing the credit counseling industry in Canada for the last 50 years. And this is what they say, this is what their CEO says about CAP's service to the poor. Henrietta Ross says, I am very proud to be associated with CAP Canada, a truly amazing organization that genuinely cares about the most vulnerable among us by helping them in a dignified way with the utmost love and respect. CAP's unique approach to supporting clients through home visits is refreshing. and extremely helpful in gaining a first-hand appreciation of a family's challenging circumstances. This extent of CAP's dedicated support for a family's well-being is unparalleled in Canada today. Can I just say that nobody else is caring for the poor the way that the local church is caring for the poor? We get it, and we do it well. And when we're in partnership with the local church and CAP today, that really leads to life transformation. The second part of our mission statement is to save the lost. And now I want to be clear before we get into theology and everything like that. I am not saying that CAP saves the lost. No way. But I do believe, of course, that salvation is a work of the Holy Spirit. And evangelism is a partnership between us and the Holy Spirit. We are proclaiming the gospel, and the Holy Spirit is drawing people towards himself. And that is a powerful thing that we can take part in. Jesus says in Luke 4, "The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is upon me because he has anointed me," and hear this, "to proclaim good news to the poor." Can I say that again? To proclaim good news to the poor. "He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free," just as Isaiah said, "to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And I know as a group of Jesus followers here at St. John's, you guys are committed to that vision, which is to know Christ, which is one part, and then to make him known. And I love the part where it says learning and growing what it means to follow Jesus and to be his disciple. And that is key. It is that disciple part that means that CAP, we only partner with the local church to reach those in need because we are pointing people to Christ. And then we are seeing them become disciples. As Jesus said, "I will build my church and nothing shall overcome it." Do you believe that today? Bill Hybels is well known for his statement in his book, Courageous Leadership. He says, "The local church is the hope of the world." He goes on to say, "There is nothing like the local church when it is working right. Its beauty is indescribable. Its power is breathtaking. Its potential is unlimited." And that is why I am here today, and that is why we only partner with the church, because your potential is unlimited. And the last part of our mission is the belief that this ministry is for the entire nation. From sea to sea to sea, we long to see this ministry in every community. We believe that CAP, in partnership with the local church, is part of God's answer and response to a massive need in our nation today. 4.9 million Canadians are living in poverty. 4.9. And the effects and the impact that this has on the lives of the vulnerable is terrible. 25% of our CAP clients say that they have missed meals on a regular basis, which is why at CAP, we take our clients out on a grocery store visit when we meet with them. 79% of our clients with children, 79% of our clients with children, this is an overwhelming stat, say that debt has affected their ability to adequately provide food or clothing for their kids. 27% of clients say that debt has caused their relationships to break down entirely. That is families being pulled apart by debt and poverty. And 38% of our clients thought that suicide was the only option for them to get out of debt. And this is the reality of many families in this community, in communities, our neighboring communities, and particularly the community that Pastor Guy is serving. The Young and Lawrence Fellowship seeks to serve people who are struggling. People experiencing devastating poverty, families and marriages that are facing that stress and that pressure of debt. They're house poor. They're working two or more jobs just to get by. A local community worker, the head librarian at Locke Library, said that in order to live in this neighborhood, it takes 2.5 salaries. And who pays that price? Well, it's the family, and it's the marriages that are paying that price. And I tell you all of that because, can you guess? There is always hope. There is always hope. And the great news is that CAP and the church in Canada have an opportunity to write a different story. And you and the church can be part of that solution, which is God's solution to reach this city and eventually this nation. And churches can partner with us in 3 different ways. Now, in each of these services, we train a local volunteer from the church to be able to offer that to the community. So we train, we equip, we resource, and you go and deliver that service. And so firstly, we have our amazing CAP Money course. This is a very simple and easy to run course, helping people to, first off, build a budget. Well, what is a budget? And then build the budget, which is where people are at sometimes. We learn to get that budget to balance. We start looking at savings. And then we learn to make good choices when we're spending money. In the last 12 months alone, over 1,400 people have been on a CAP Money course here in Canada. This thing works, and it is completely needed. When we look at the stats, almost 50% of working Canadians say that they would be in trouble if their paycheck were delayed by 1 week. 50% of Canadians say they would not know what to do if their paycheck was delayed 1 week. 33% of Canadians say that they cannot, 33, I read these stats and it just becomes so natural to me, but I'm reading it again like it's the first time for some reason. And 33% of our Canadians say that they are not able to pay their monthly bills on time. This is amazing. So there is such a huge need in our communities for the wisdom that this course brings. And so I'm happy to say that there are coaches, Dio, James, Guy, there are people here that are going to run this course in this community starting April 28th. And after the service, I would love to encourage all of you, please sign up. Even if you have your finances in control, what I would ask is that you come to just know what the course is about. So when you tell other people that you meet who are struggling, you can help them to understand what it is about and just be an advocate for that course. And so please do see the team after the service. The second way churches can partner with us is through our debt centers. And this really is the heart of CAP. It is for people who are already overwhelmed with debt. Now, sometimes a course is just too late to help those people that are already struggling. And so our debt centers is there for them. A CAP debt center enables the church to reach those who are overwhelmed with unmanageable debt. And again, we train an individual from the church to run that local debt center. They visit clients in their home. And let me be clear, this is a completely free service to support people on that journey of actually becoming debt-free. So CAP trains and you deliver. And so CAP is doing the credit counseling centrally at head office in Hamilton, where our team are qualified credit counselors. We have all our designations. And we're able to create budgets, negotiate with creditors, and provide advice to clients that will free them from debt. And the last way that churches can partner with us is to run a CAP job club. And job clubs are amazing. They are designed to provide a community connection as well as a course to help people who are struggling, to help them find employment. It helps to rebuild confidence and self-esteem. And it is just a regular supportive community that is, yeah, in a church where people love them. We have the privilege of being able to rewrite stories and to see what happens when God steps in, when God shines his light in those dark places. Now, I gave you a taster of John's story that clearly demonstrates God's ability to kind of turn around even sort of those darkest of situations. And today, I want to give you all a book, nevertheless, for free. When I read this book, I'm going to be honest, I was really, really challenged by it. And you will be too, and you'll find out why. So you have to get the book to find out why. But I was also inspired by what God can do with a man who has this nevertheless spirit to keep on serving those that are struggling, serving the poor. And so all I would ask for you to do, does everybody have one of these forms on there or around them or close by? And if not, yeah, you can pick one up from my husband, Mark, or myself. If you would like a copy of this book, which again, I encourage you all to get this because it is John's story, his journal entries about how CAP started. All you need to do is fill out the left-hand side of the form. And as I sit in the first service, you fill out your form, you get a book. No form? No book. There you go. So great. And so as you take a few minutes to start filling out that form, I'm going to have you guys watch a video. Now, this is a video of some of our Canadian clients, Preet, Lauren, and Michelle. And just to give you an understanding of the impact that this debt center and the CAP work has on the lives of the vulnerable. Thank you.
Being in debt made me feel like I wasn't really worth much.
I always felt alone.
It's something that consumes you, a nightmare. It was almost like drowning in quicksand. I didn't know what to do.
I felt very isolated, very ashamed. I actually got very, very depressed. Maybe it would be better if I didn't wake up tomorrow morning, just because of how much debt I was in.
I got myself into a real jam with credit cards. Daily, I would get so many phone calls, and I stopped answering the phone for a while, which just made matters worse. Then came the threats for lawyers.
It was like each one of them had a shovel, and they were digging a deeper and deeper and deeper hole for me that I couldn't. It was taking away the light from my life and the hope.
It got to a point where I couldn't pay anymore. Even the minimums I couldn't handle. All I thought about 24/7 was, how am I going to get out of this mess?
So it just kind of progressively got into a cycle I just couldn't get out of. Then I found CAP.
It took me 3 weeks to even work up the courage to be able to call them. And I was just worried that I was going to be so judged.
That first phone call to CAP actually was it was a help right off the start. I didn't feel like I was being judged. She understood my situation, and she gave me some hope that CAP could help me out with this. And for the first time, I actually felt like somebody was on my team.
When I called CAP, I finally felt listened to. CAP accepted me for who I was. I felt as though I was normal.
The best part about CAP is not having to deal with the creditors and being able to have them speak to CAP representatives instead of constantly calling me.
CAP has made a big difference in my life. They became a buffer between the creditors and myself because I really had no solution.
When I started working with Christians Against Poverty, I was able to see how God still cared about me and that he was there with me every step of the way as well. I realize now that without him, I would still be in that big financial mess. I don't even know if I would have still been here, to be honest.
CAP brings scripture to life. I can see God working through CAP. And that is and has been very important and very dear to me.
The practical support that I received from CAP, the availability, whenever I had questions or I needed to talk to CAP, there was always people there to take my call. The other thing that I gained from CAP was an introduction to church. I noticed that CAP, you know, like, they're godly people helping others. And I could learn a lot from that. I spent a lot of time in my life being selfish, not helping other people as much as I could have. Now I start to see the worth in it, and I want to be like that. I feel much better and much more confident and much more serene, which is important to me because I lived a lot of anxiety and things like that, and that seems to be washed away by Jesus. I'm just giving my will over to the Lord because of all this. And it all started with the debt and CAP, and you know, it's mushroomed into this great things for me.
I would like to thank anybody who's made any kind of a donation. You are really doing a good work. You are participating in God's plan, and you are helping so many people. There are people going debt-free because Christians Against Poverty has taken the time to do this for us.
Thank you for being Christians Against Poverty.
Thank you for being Christians Against Poverty.
Thank you for being Christians Against Poverty.
Yeah, that right there is the very reason why I do what I do and why we exist here in Canada. That is an amazing, great clients that we have, an inspiration to us all. And so finally today, I would love to give you all the opportunity to give and get involved with this mission, either by being trained to run one of the services or to become a monthly supporter and become a life changer. And life changers are what we call the amazing people who regularly support the work. And now you've heard from me today about who we are and what we do and why we do it. We are Christians Against Poverty, and we exist to serve the poor, to save the lost with the church and across this nation. And almost we have 900 regular givers, and we aim to end this year with 1,000 regular givers so we can continue to do this and to continue to partner with more churches as we reach more communities one life at a time. We have an incredible vision for the GTA over the next 3 years to open 32 new debt centers. And the hope is that we will come to this 3 years from now where we are celebrating as hundreds of people are going debt-free and hundreds of people are finding work. And more important, hundreds of people are meeting Jesus for the first time. And we cannot do that without your support. And so I am asking you today, will you give a few dollars every month to the work of CAP? And I'm not asking for myself or for CAP as an organization, but for beautiful folks like Preet and Michelle, who has a job now and she is getting debt-free, which is amazing, and Lauren as well, who is well on her way. More beautiful people that we can help through your generosity. And now an average life changer is $25 a day or a month, which is $6 a week, but any amount makes a huge difference. So if you would like to become a life changer, all I ask is that you fill out the right-hand side of the form. You can put your credit card details or include a void check. And if you don't know those details, I'd be happy just to give you a call later this week to get those set up over the phone. And so on behalf of the CAP team at head office, they know I'm here. They are praying for you guys specifically to just get involved on behalf of our clients that we get to reach and will continue to reach because of your support. Thank you.